death is coming.
Hello everyone, welcome to Conan Exiles Age of War Let's Play series. This is episode 28. Today we are continuing the Dungeon Delver with the Wine Cellar. And I believe it's the last dungeon from this journey. So for this, let's take Tugra with us. Let's take the horse. And there are two ways. By the way, I made Tugra a full set. Redeem full set of strength armor. Best strength armor for Thralls. Redeem Legion helmet. Voidforged dragon ribs. Silent Legion medium gauntlets. Champion leggings and perfected heavy sabatons. And with bulk plating also, as Aya's Bane with Grandmaster weapon fitting on it. Also made myself a mace with Grandmaster weapon fitting. Now, there are two ways to go to the Wine Cellar. Either we teleport to Clael's Stronghold at the obelisk and then head through the through Sepemero by the lake where the behind Conan's bar, or what I like to do if I'm pretty far away, but it's just more of a gimmick. Gimmick the potion of midnight. Do we have 15? Yeah, we can make. Let's just make 15 yellow lotus powder to make a potion. We have elixir of might, cooked pork. We have food, we have everything we need. Now this dungeon, it's supposed to be the hardest, and it is kind of hard to do. Especially the last boss, which is Tug. It's called Tug. And it's the only boss that has actually mechanics that you have to avoid. So we will see when we get to the last boss. We have the golden lotus, the yellow lotus. Let's just make a potion of midnight. Practically, we will be teleported inside the midnight grove. And if we come to the to this pool at the entrance and we interact with it, we will be teleported just next to the dungeon entrance behind Conan's bar, as you see here. Now, because I'm in single player, the NPCs just start popping in. Anything good? Just let the game load a bit. With this occasion, might as well just look and see if the bear is a good one. Nah, just a bearer too. But I believe everything is loaded in. Let's just go inside the dungeon. So, as you see, this is the Conan bar. And if we go behind it, you have this door by the lake, which says enter. We can interact with it and it will teleport us into the dungeon. Let's see if it triggers the journey step. Let's just make Tugra beat this guy up. Yeah, he's down. Oh wow. And actually give us said truncheon. This is the best truncheon in the game, in Exile Lands. Because there is one more that you can make, but it's on Island of Sipta. And now we cannot teleport between between the maps. Let's just buff our Thrall to make him even tougher. Now let's just... Okay, so it gave us the Wine Cellar. Find the Wine Cellar. I will not loot anything from these guys. Let's just go deeper into the cave. This is one of my favorite dungeons. Now if we go further, there will be more relic hunters. Come on, Tugra. Ooh, a harp. Let's just get it. Now, if we go inside these ruins, you can find some chests and also some lore books. But mainly we are looking for little chests that may contain Kari steel. And you will see at the last boss. The last boss will drop some recipes. Now go further down and we will have some more relic hunters, and on the right there will be a mini boss relic hunter that will drop Heart of a Hero. Let's just take the Heart of a Hero and the soup. We will not take the spiced stuff. Let's see, more chests. I believe also this dungeon will be very good in chapter 2. I don't think there is any Kari still here, but if we walk back to the last camp, there was one relic hunter, and we go behind the tent on this ledge. Usually there are two, now there is only one chest, and if you interact with it, it will give you 3 Kari. So the armors and weapons that you can find on the last boss, the recipes, you will need Kari steel to make the armors and weapons. More relic hunters here. Now, there is a ledge here, and you have to jump it. Now, if you cannot make this jump, and you, I don't know, end up on the ledge or something like that, and you cannot climb back, just jump in the void, because it will bring you to the entrance, and you will not lose anything. Now it begins with the skeletons. There is a bit of a maze in here also, but in my opinion it's done pretty good. Also more lore books. Pretty nice dungeon. Now in these ruins you will find not a lot, but you will find Kari still. You will find little chests. I will show you some. I don't think I will remember all, but I will show you some. A lot of skeletons inside here. Go down. Tugra, why are you not fighting? That is my question. Now, the maze skeletons here do a lot of damage, so be careful. Also the pokey guys.
Your soul.
Another lore book. Might as well, but we should not take everything here. It seems like Tugra is pretty buggy inside this dungeon. My health took a beating. Now let's take a look. Usually there are some chests behind these buildings. And also you can find Kari still. Now, don't bash me in the comments if I miss anything, because it's pretty hard to do a walkthrough and also see everything. More chests. Ooh, and a legendary blessed Black Tusk shield. I will not pick it up. I have one at home. And also, I'm at 50%, so let me put something on the horse. Like this Kari steel. This harp. Yeah, this advanced tool upgrade kits weigh a bit. Forty-six, good. Now, let's move on. Another chest. More chests. A lot of chests I see. I believe they supplemented the chests in this dungeon. I don't remember being that many. A Grey Lotus potion, might as well take it. There should be a boss here. Yes, this hammer guy does a lot of damage. So be careful. Like that. Good that he doesn't have that much health. And also these bosses give Kari steel. There should be more. I'm definitely passing some of them. But it is pretty much a maze here. More skeletons. Ooh, a lot with maces. Ooh, potion of elixir of might. Nice. Come on, Kari steel. Now, like I said in a previous video, it is possible that on the servers there will be more loot inside these dungeons. Because they... Did I take this? Because there are more people on the server and they usually put more things inside the servers. Now I don't seem to find more Kari steel for some reason. Treasure. You know, when you come to this well, you have to take a left, and you will come to this bridge to continue, or go also another left to find more chests. There should be carry still somewhere around here, who allege. Well. For example, the place I found the carry chest on the beginning of the dungeon, behind that relic hunter tent. Usually on the server there are 2-3, something like that, chests like that, and you can easily get 10 from that. That's why I see it's possible that there are fewer chests. Where is Tugra? He doesn't seem to want to fight. Oh, he's on that guy. Pot and compost, let's take it. I'm over 50% encumbrance. Nah. Oh, this one weighs a lot. Now here there should be a Triskal undead kappa. Let's see. No carries still. They usually fight the undead here. Oof. Oh yes, and we got the Kari water skin. Nice. I believe this one has a healing effect or something like that. I can't remember. Does it drop a key? No. This doesn't weigh that much. Let's just take a rhino soup. And we also actually can take the elixir. We didn't took it when we entered the dungeon. Let's see. More chests. A lot of silver and gold. Now, I remember on official server there was a carry chest here. Let's see behind this. No. I'm not getting too lucky with the carry still. Unfortunately. I don't remember being emotes here. Or recipes laying on the floor. Another chest. This dungeon is stingy with me with the curry. It doesn't matter. Grey Lotus Seeds. There should be another boss around here somewhere. Now, if you get to this intersection, you can go straight and get to the boss, or you take a left. And you will get to a bridge and an island with some skeletons and a skeleton boss. Let's just go towards the bridge, cross the bridge. There should be a mini boss there. Attack Tugra. It does a lot. This maze guys do a lot of damage with the hammer. Some chests with gold and other stuff. Oh, silver. And there should be... what is this? Oh, Sorcerer's Scroll page. Press E to interact. Now, like I said before, on server there are more chests. On servers I found two Kare Steel chests here. Now there are none. But I see there is an E here. I believe it's from this torch. Anyway, let's go back. Now we follow the road to the left. There should be a boss here. That is a spear guy. You can call them mini bosses if you like. More Kare Steel fragments of power. How many do we have? 8. Well, that is not good. There should be more chests around here. Three more chests, silver and gold, other stuff, grey lotus flowers, also can drop seeds here. Either I'm blind or the chests do not appear. Also probably missed a couple of them, but I kinda looked in all these buildings. Nah. I don't see any more. More skeletons. I was about to fall. Lucky that we have the heavy armor on us. It protects us very good. A lot more chests. Carry chest. Carry steel chests. Nope, it doesn't want to. Well, what can you do? Another lore book. Let's just repair our glowing stick. Let's see what we find behind this building. We were here. Yeah, not that lucky with the curry steel. Now we get to the final part of the dungeon. Tugra, go get them. No car is still here either. Another boss. Nice sword you have there. Ooh, that was a big damage. Lucky that we have the regenerating perk. The resurgence, I believe. Gluten for punishment. When you take damage, you regenerate the last instance of damage taken over 15 seconds. If we don't take damage in 15 seconds, we regenerate all that. So basically we can get down to 1 health. And if we don't take damage, we regenerate 700. Or what we have. Yeah, no, the car still is eluding me somehow. I cannot find it for some reason. The most carry still I got from these dungeons was around 44 or something like that. So you don't get much, but you'll be able to make at least one weapon. Something like that. Now I don't see that many chests. I believe only 2 chests or 1 chest we got from this dungeon, which is pretty ridiculous in my opinion. Usually there are behind these buildings. Wait there, do not block me. No, I don't see anything. Nah. Well, that's okay. Now this is the last 100 meters of the dungeon. You have this road that goes up. And now on the right you will have a demon spider boss and a lot of gossamer if you want. Also some spiders, normal spiders. Actually, there are a lot of small spiders here. Yeah. As you see, there is gossamer all over the place. Can easily get 1,500 or something like that, maybe more. And the demon spider. And he's down. And he actually drops a skeleton key in the back of the cave. You have some normal chests, but a legendary one. Oh, nice, another Black Broarg Fury. It's nice because I use it, so if this one gets damaged, but as you see, I don't really use it that much, especially in case where it's dark, because I need to use the torch. Yeah, I can do the magic, but like I said in the previous video, I don't like the wisp. The wisp is annoying. Maybe if you radiate a light from yourself, from the body, like this, but green, it would be good. But as it stands, the movement of the wisp bothers me a lot. So that's why I don't use it. And there is the room of the final boss. But before that, we have more skeletons here. Some skeleton lizard man. Believe it's 2 or 3. There's nothing important here. No chests. Actually, I believe there is one chest on the other side, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we will go. Was there a chest? I remember being a chest here. And here we are at the final boss. Now, how will this work? So, you have to light all these fires. There are 6 fires. And the door behind you will close and you have to fight it. You don't have a choice. So let's just start the fires. I'll bring up my shield even if it's a bit darker. And let's just fight the boss. Yes, 24,000. You just bleed him a bit. Oh, he doesn't bleed. Interesting. Let's just put some. You know, he will do some mechanics, and you have to be careful not to stay in that blue stuff. Yeah, he does this again. Yeah, I got hit. Does a lot of damage when he does that. And the last phase, this one, will summon skeletons, blue skeletons. Which are annoying. Oh shit. Now that shouldn't have... Oh shit. I'm almost out. I'm crippled. Now if the boss dies, these skeletons will also die. Another mechanics. We have to be very, very careful. Yeah. Very careful. Get him. There are a lot of skeletons. Now Tugra does pretty good. I was expecting him to not do that great. He does pretty good, actually. Get the boss. Yes, he's dead. And we finish the dungeon Delver. And if we claim this, we will learn the Ranger armor. And the Ranger armor is considered medium armor, but it has light armor stats. I don't know why. We will see, we'll make one when we get home. Just to show you the stats of it. Anything good? Nothing. And the boss has carry steel on him and a treasure. And what we... Yeah, carry weapons. Nice. We got the recipe for carry weapons. If we learn this, carry bow, carry pike, carry hammer, great sword. Very good. Is this carry? No. Which one is carry? Only two-handed. So this is the carry sword, 45. And which one is it? The star metal is 51. Oh, okay, so he doesn't have that much. Carry daggers, 27, 30. And carry bow, 25. Yeah, this one is pretty good. The carry bow, I believe, is the best. If you make it with a named a bow maker. No, this is not the way. On the other side, the cell doors are opened, and we can go through this crack. It will teleport us to the surface. Yes, on the other door. Okay, where is my horse? Now I will teleport back home and I will see you there. Here we are back home. Let's take a look at the weapons. So it should be carry steel. Okay, so this one is 10, we have 14. 38. Let's make a pair of daggers. I'm curious if it's anything special. Also, I hope I have enough to make a bow, but we will see. Okay, let's see if the daggers have anything special. No. And also have very, very low durability. Interesting. I guess you can put this as a skin for your main daggers, I guess. I'm sure they look pretty good. Now let's take a look at the bow first. Let's take a look at the bow. Where is the carry bow? Am I missing something? This one, oh, is 15 still. Okay, so 10 if we have the precision carpenter. So we don't have to make it. Also the armorer, the ranger armor. Let's see if we can make it. We need thick hide and layered silk. So thick hide we have a lot. But unfortunately we don't have the layered silk. So let me just make some. Let's just make 125 and I'll bring you guys back when I get everything. Well, I think we have enough to make the armor. Let's just take what we have for now. It's a long time I've been waiting. So first let's make the perfected light paddings. So we need 5 of them. And now let's make a full set of armors with the armorsmith. Okay, so now we have the full set. If we take a look at it, let's just equip everything. So every piece has plus 8% agility weapon damage and plus 7 stamina with the shield ride. As you see, everything is the same, but has stats of light armor, unfortunately, and it says medium armor. But even the material is for light armor. I don't know what it is. It is what it is. If I were you, I would put bulk plating on them. Now there will be a problem with the weight, but there are some weapons that don't weigh that much. So this will give you plus 40% agility weapon damage. And in my opinion, it's pretty neat. It looks pretty good. Okay, so this is it for today. I put some polls on community. If you want to vote, please vote for the next build that I'm going to play on Sita in about a week, beginning on Monday. So this is the antepenultimate episode. On Monday we will have we still have to find all the pieces to leave the exile lands to finish this play, and also we have two more dungeons, the Frost Temple and the dungeon of the Kurak dungeon. And I believe on Monday I will do the Kurak dungeon and also the Frost Temple, both of them. I hope they don't take 1 hour or more. We will see. And on Friday we'll have all the pieces that we need to remove our bracelet to leave the Exile Lands, and on Monday we'll begin the Sipta. So please vote on the community post, and why not give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye bye.